Estate Investing Profits presents Profit Masters with your host, world-renowned real estate coach and investor, Corey Boatwright. Now, strap in and get ready to learn elite wealth-building investment strategies taught by six- and seven-figure house-flipping masters as they reveal their best real estate investing profit secrets to you right now.
We are back. This is Corey Boatwright. I am the founder of Real Estate Investing Profits and your host for Profit Master podcast series. I appreciate you taking the time to be on here. Now, last week, we had Dave Payerchin, okay? And this week, we have RJ Pepino, all right? And RJ is the partner with Dave in Columbus Turnkey Houses. Have you heard of them? They're pretty extraordinary. They provide some incredible return on profits for you doing your investing in Columbus. Now, what's interesting with them is Dave handles a lot of the networking, raising capital, assist automation. RJ, what he does is he's closed over 150 real estate transactions. He's an expert in the Columbus market. He's had formal training in deal structuring, creative financing, and he's also went to Youngstown State University. He's got a BA in marketing management from Youngstown. The guy is really sharp and a guy I can call friend. Both of Dave and RJ are friends from the Collective Genius Mastermind. If you haven't checked that out yet, or I'll have it right here on the show notes. It's an incredible real estate mastermind, some of the best and top minds in the country, and they're no exception. So I want you to go ahead and put things aside and focused and listen to this interview I had with RJ as he's going to talk to you about how he helps run the Columbus Turnkey Houses with Dave Payerchin. So, oh, by the way, don't forget to make sure you text the word profit to 38470 and get your real estate investing guide. It's absolutely free. We have a ton of great comments and people getting success from just reading the book. So there you go. I will talk to you next week. And here's RJ. RJ, my man, what's going on?
Hey, Corey, what's up?
How are you, bro?
I'm doing well, man. I'm doing good. Thanks for having me here.
Thanks for coming on. You know, your partner, Dave, just lifted you up so much. I thought it just made a lot of sense just to have you right next as the next interview because, man, he was just you guys sound like you have a fantastic partnership. And I'd like to ask you a little bit more about that in a bit. But why don't you take just a few minutes to explain a little bit who you are and what's your expertise in real estate?
Gotcha. Yeah, my name is RJ Pepino, and I'm here in Columbus, Ohio. You know, our main business is selling rental properties to out-of-town investors. A lot of them are out of town. Some of them are in town. And we just show them how to basically become buy-and-hold investors. And, you know, we provide the property management. And we also, another part of our business is also buy and hold ourselves. So we have a lot of experience with that. I started out with real estate on the wholesaling end and flipping a bunch of properties, selling contracts basically. And then it led me to raise some private capital and start keeping a lot of these good deals that I was passing along. You know, I was seeing the numbers.
Right.
And all the investors that I was selling these properties to, they're telling me like, hey, I killed it. I made, you know, 15, 20 grand on this flip,
right?
30, 40, 50 grand on that flip. Thank you. And I'm thinking, you know, I made like 5 to 10 grand. I'm like, oh man, I need to make those big checks. You know,
yes, yes. I
had a big buyer who was one of the bigger landlords here in Columbus. And I was talking to him one day after I flipped the property, made 5 grand. And he was showing me his bank rolls of properties that he was holding. And he was just, you know, I wake up on the first and 40 grand just hits my account. I'm like, okay, got me thinking.
I want that. Yeah.
I definitely want that. And his lifestyle, super relaxed guy, smokes cigars, goes golfing.
Just chill.
He's just chill, you know? And I'm like, all right, I got to do something. I'm young, don't have a family yet. How do I get into the rental game? And it led me to kind of investigate that, how it really works, raised some private money with Dave. This was back in 2011, tail end of 2011. We started buying and holding properties, and a lot of the investors who were flipping these properties to got curious because I hadn't sent out an email, and it had been like 4 or 5 months, and they were asking me, "Hey, what's going on? You guys still in business? What's new?"
We need to buy something. What's going on?
Told them like, "Hey, we had to keep some of the ones that we were selling.
They're too good of deals,
right?" And then, some of them were like, "Yeah, we're looking for deals like that too. What do you got?" So that kind of spurred the whole turnkey investing. It was kind of almost by accident. And we also saw that, there's still some pretty good margins in these turnkey flips. So why not keep some, sell some, and use some of those profits to get into more rental properties?
Yeah. So that kind of answers the question of what made you want to get involved with real estate. That sounds like that guy that had the buy and hold, and that really encouraged you to jump in and do the real estate game. Is that accurate?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Very much so. He was someone that showed me what kind of lifestyle you could have with cash flow. There's a lot of work that goes into finding the deal, fixing up the deal, and selling the deal.
It's very transactional, though, at that point, right?
It is. And it's also now that I've got some more knowledge with it, it's a very highly taxable event. A lot of capital gains tax you got to pay. So that, back in 2011, it really kind of opened my eyes to switch a little bit of the strategy of what I wanted to do, which is build wealth. Right now, we've got about 40. And our goal is to get to 100. Some different strategies there that we're trying to implement, some creative financing stuff and some owner financing. But, we're still doing it. We're still actively raising money.
That's awesome.
And building our portfolio and then helping investors.
It's interesting you mentioned this. Whenever you're I'm also have several properties. Whenever you own properties, you have a portfolio or just any property, you get four different types a revenue. So you get appreciation, you get depreciation, mm-hmm. right? You get cash flow, and then you get income, right? So there's four different ways of making money whenever you're a landlord compared to just flipping houses, right? Or
right.
not flipping houses when you're actually fixing them up and flipping them, or just wholesaling, which flipping contracts on houses. So sure, it's definitely a longer term game, but I do think it's smarter to get involved right in the beginning if you're wanting to learn about the business wholesaling and just flipping those contracts, because you learn so much, you meet different people, and it's just a way you can make a pretty good chunk of money. I know guys that make 15, 20 grand a month, flipping contracts on houses for a couple of houses.
Yeah.
And it's not a big deal to them. So it's a lifestyle business too.
Yes.
And then when you create a system around it, then you can really, you do some bigger numbers with it too. But I love that idea of appreciation, depreciation, cash flow, and income. What was when you're, was there a breaking point in your life where, I ask all of the guys that have come on here and gals that have come on here, was there a breaking point that you had that you said enough was enough? Were you working another job before where it's just like, this is going nowhere and I got to do something different? There's a bigger calling in my life.
Yeah. you're right. I was at a job. I had been working, at a retail job selling cell phones, AT&T. Before that, it was Singular. So let me take you back to kind of when I was in college. I went to Youngstown State on a tennis scholarship, and so I did real well there. And I got hurt. It's kind of a cliche story, but I did get hurt. And my last year, and I had these hopes of going down to Florida and trying the satellites out. It's kind of like the minor leagues of tennis.
Wow.
Kind of dream went away, and I'm thinking there, I had this like moment where I'm like, all right, what do I do here? I need to make some money. And one of my friends in college was killing it and selling cell phones. And so I tried my knack in that. And I did real well. I was just, I don't know, I was just kind of aggressive and assumptively closed a lot of people buying cell phones.
Right.
And so I moved up in the company. This is back in Youngstown. And I moved up pretty high in the company to get into management. And my plan back then was to kind of climb that ladder. And, you know, I wanted to get into corporate. I you know, went through several interviews to get into corporate. And time and time again, they just said, hey, you know, you did this, this, and that, but you don't have the experience. You know, it was always that.
Right.
And then after that last interview, I sat there in my car. I knew I didn't get it because I just had to. It's like you go through so many interviews, you just have that feeling. And I'm sitting there. I mean, I got to do something else. You know, that was the defining moment. I sat in my car. I'm like, what else is there? I was driving back from the interview and I got a phone call from my brother. And my brother and I, my brother was in Columbus. My brother and I had always thought of doing something, you know, like starting our own restaurant business.
One of these days, man, yeah, we're like, going to be, you know, we're going to be business owners. Right.
Yeah. And he came across a book. The book was called Rich Dad, Poor Dad.
Sure. Yeah.
And he was just like, RJ called me. I remember this phone call. I was like, you have got to check this book out. It'll completely change everything for you.
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right, I'm driving. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to go get this book right now. I went to the Borders bookstore and I got it and I read it that night.
Wow. I got
like several chapters and I'm like, oh my God, this is amazing. I didn't even know this stuff existed out there, you know? So that kind of changed my whole outlook on what I wanted to do.
Right.
And one of the vehicles in that book was real estate.
Mm-hmm.
And he told me, my brother told me that there was a seminar later that month, and it was like a 3-day type seminar or something like that. And I went to that seminar, sat down there, and I was just, you know, some guys on stage, and he's showing you like all the cool things he's done, and real estate's the, you know, super sexy. So I was hooked after that, and I didn't have the cash to pay the $25,000. You know, coaching program. So I did some more research, very good at that, you know, researching how I can get involved with not that much money.
Right. You got enough to be able to take it, right? And investigate more. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I had some savings, but I didn't have all that lump sum to come up, you know, and pay that. So I stumbled upon some guy who was doing wholesaling on the internet. And that was it. You know, his program, his sales page was awesome.
Who was one of your big influences for investing?
It doesn't
have to be a guru necessarily.
Yeah. So definitely the Rich Dad, Poor Dad, all those books, was it Robert Kiyosaki?
Right.
So he's definitely a big influence, kind of changed my mindset a lot. And then, some of the internet guys, I found somebody locally actually through all that mess on the internet. I found somebody locally, and I think you might have know him. His name's Darren Dickey.
Yeah.
And he's,
I want to get him on the show.
Yeah. I should, text him.
That'd be great, man. Do that. Please do that'd be great. Connect with him. It's been a while. Yep.
So he was one of the biggest influences here locally because, you know, the guy that was, I don't want to badmouth that guy, but he was, he had a lot of good strategies, a lot of things implemented to get the phone ringing. But when it came down to really knowing your market, definitely find somebody locally that's doing what you're doing. And so I found Darren, and we ended up doing a deal like a month and a half after doing his coaching. He's one of the big influences. And at that time he was doing stuff with Colin. They had like a coaching program together.
That was a real estate investor.
Yeah.
Yep.
Real estate investor.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Colin was, I'd known Colin for a long time. He went through some, all kinds of ups and downs, and they had a whirlwind of a business. Sam came out of that business too. Sam was working with Colin. Mm-hmm. You know, some good peeps there. That'd be great. Yeah. I appreciate if you, do the invite for Darren. I hadn't talked to him in a while.
Awesome. I can do that. Yeah. So that was, to go back to your question, that was like, I'm in my car. I'm feeling, you know, just absolutely like crap. I'm, you know, and I knew there's something there, something better that I could do. And It was all because of that phone call from my brother. I'm very grateful for that. I'm also grateful for meeting those guys that are involved in real estate. And that was it, man. I mean, I took action. You know, I'm an action taker type of guy.
Right.
I was super nervous when I was taking those coaching calls and taking those seller calls and meeting the seller. No experience at all, you know?
Right.
I didn't know what to look for plumbing, electric, and anything like that, but it worked out.
It just worked out. Right. Well, what's a big mistake that you made with real estate and how did you get through it?
Oh, man. I would say the biggest mistake I've ever did was to not have proper contracts, agreements with contractors.
Okay.
Absolutely. You need to have a, you know, whatever
did something
it's called.
Happen
it's called
that,
like
that,
a, an independent that, contractor. Yes. Okay. Yes. There was a deal that we did. I had done several deals before with this contractor because he also flipped houses.
Okay.
And I had the buyer on a couple transactions that I did with this contractor. Man. And so we had a house that we were going to do and flip to my buyer, and the renovation costs were going to be right around, like $40,000. Okay. And the agreement was that I would put up the rehab funds and he would find the house and do the deal. Well, I didn't have any, you know, agreements in place. It's more of like a handshake deal, and you don't want to do any handshake deals in real estate at all. Sure. You got to protect yourself.
Sure.
To make a long story short, I never saw that contractor again, and he ran off with a pretty big, large amount of money. Okay. So one that really hurt me because I had a business partner starting out in the wholesaling. And we kind of went a different direction. So I was kind of by myself. And, you know, that was a big chunk of, you know, my savings that I threw out there. And, you know, I was in a tough spot, you know. And so, you know, my lesson learned on that is definitely have proper agreements in place. You know, what you're going to do, what they're supposed to do, how you can protect yourself in there, make sure there's certain agreements that you can protect your money. And not give up a big lump sum of rehab funds like that.
It's no great, bueno. It's a great resource. Yeah, no bueno. There's a great resource called Rocket Lawyer that it's for folks that don't know how to find an attorney. Rocket Lawyer is actually very good. There's a number of folks I know that use it and had great success with it. So I think having agreements, especially when you working with contractors, it's so important to make sure that you're protected.
Absolutely. Yeah. I know. That was an expensive lesson.
That was an expensive lesson.
Now I'm a better investor.
It could be more expensive though, right? So there's always a silver lining. What's we have the guest on here and discuss the Profit Master investing strategy. And I know that's what you are working with, Dave, and he talked about the buy and hold mold model as one of his Profit Master investing strategies, which you guys work together. Do you have that same one, or do you want to talk about a different one that's working well for you? One of the best strategies. This could be a marketing strategy. It doesn't have to be necessarily the business model.
Yeah. I'd like to share, you know, one of the biggest things that we're doing is we're still in our building phase. So we're, you know, we hired a couple of sales reps.
Okay.
And we're training them to get really, really good on the phone.
Okay.
And
how are you training them?
So we're doing we're taking live calls with them.
Okay.
And then after the call is over, then we're going to like critique them.
Okay.
Ask them why because there's tendencies that when we're on the phone or under pressure that we're going to, that kind of comes out, you know, and we talk about that and then help them with certain strategies that we use when we're on the phone.
Right.
And I guess one of the things that I've been kind of, telling my new sales guy's Mo, and he just did his first deal and, you know, he's super excited and it's awesome for him to see that. It just makes you feel good, you know?
Right.
One of the strategies is to, when you're talking to a seller, you know, one of the questions that you have to ask good questions. And one of the questions that we have them ask is, you know, if they called in about one property, is there any other properties that you have for sale?
Mm-hmm.
Are they in the market to buy properties? And another question is, if they're not interested in selling at our price point, do they know if they have, do they know anybody that's around them that's looking to sell? So those three questions can, I mean, open the floodgates. It could be a buyer, you know, they're selling a property. They might be a buyer. They might have not only this property for sale, but multiple properties
for
sale.
Other properties, right? Yep.
And all you're doing is just asking, and it takes you like less than 5 minutes to ask those questions, but it can open more business and more doors.
I love that. And it's a simple little tactic like that that can make an extra 10, 20, I mean, depending on where you are, a lot of extra money just from asking a simple little question like that. So that's perfect.
Yeah. And it's, you know, you're turning a seller into a buyer, or if you're talking to a buyer, ask them the same question. Well, you know, you're looking to buy properties. Do you have any for sale? Because we're in the market to buy. We're always looking to buy.
Right.
You know, so it's huge. And it's increasing our deal flow by one or two deals.
Yeah, I was going to say how much. So it's about one or two deals a month on that by doing it that way.
Right. So every seller is turning out that one out of five sellers is turning out to be still in the game, still wanting to buy. And then asking that question of, you know, do you have any other properties for sale? Yeah, they got like two or three other properties that, you know, they're, you know, motivated to sell, not just this one. So it's cool. It's good. It's good to see that strategy kind of come to fruition for us.
What's one piece of advice that you'd share about running a successful business?
Oh, man. You definitely have to delegate and hire people. You can't do it all on your own. You know, I'm very grateful to have a good business partner that understands that. And, you know, we complement each other a lot. But you gotta, so eventually the task of getting on the phones and talking to sellers, eventually you have to get somebody that can do that for you, because you're going to be able to do more deals. You know, you can't do it all. You can't wear all the hats. So, you know, there's a book that I'm actually reading right now. It's called by Gino Wickman.
A Rocket Fuel
Fuel.
Is it Rocket Fuel?
Rocket Fuel is the one that I just finished reading.
Yeah.
And the one I'm reading now is called Traction.
Traction. Yeah.
A lot of good stuff there, and you know, we're building our team. We got to put some more people in place right now, but eventually. You got to delegate all that stuff out, but do it strategically. Make sure that you have what you're wanting them to do kind of outlined,
right?
Or else, you know, they're just, you know, you can't want something done where you don't know what you want done.
Right.
I'm saying you got to know what you want.
Look at this.
Learned that. There it is. Great book, man. Yeah, what is that? The Art of Mastery, something?
Yeah. Which one? Yeah. The which one were you looking at? I've got Miracle Morning. There's so many on here, but that's the Rocket Fuel is what I was. Yeah. There it is right there.
It's an awesome book.
Awesome book, man. Yeah. That's killer. Killer, killer, killer book. I agree. It's the way it's explained is in simple language too, which I really like.
Yeah. Visionary integrator.
Yeah, that's right. The visionary or the integrator? Which one? If you had to choose which one, which one are you? Yeah, it's a good question to ask. The Kobe. Anyway, we can go into that later. If you had to start like all over again, what would you change in your business?
That's a good question. I would probably change the strategy of how many properties we're going to flip and how many we're going to hold. Okay. In the beginning, what's important to a business is cash flow. And there were times when, you know, when we were building the buy and hold, we're still continually building, but that cash flow, as it's building, you still have to flip properties, you know, and, right. And there was several, you know, there were several tight months that it's like, all right, we haven't really engaged our buyers list. They haven't heard from us in a while. I don't even know if they're still buying, you know. So It was tight. It was tight those months. And so if I was to go back, I'd still continue to flip, because you definitely need that income now. And the rental property portfolio, it's a slow roll, right? But in the end, it's going to pay off.
Right. But you don't, I mean, you got to have some money to live, right? You got to have, unless you don't have stuff just set aside, the cash flow of almost the money is going on those 5-year notes that you guys are putting on. It's not much cash flow at all.
Yeah. So for guys that are going to get into the buy and hold, definitely still flip properties, create those relationships with your buyers. Because it's not a get rich quick. It's not, you're building wealth. Right. It doesn't happen overnight, and you need to pay your bills. You know, some investors or some guys that are in this business, they still have the full-time job, and that's fine. But, you know, I had no full-time job. This was it.
Right.
You know? Continue flipping, build that rental portfolio, and you'll be fine.
What books do you recommend? You mentioned Rocket Fuel is a good one, and Traction. What books do you recommend? And one of them that's really changed your life? I mean, Rich Dad Poor Dad's been a huge one.
Rich Dad Poor Dad is, I have several. More recently, I've been working a lot on my mindset, reading a lot of spiritual books. Any books by Dolores Cannon,
interesting.
Awesome. Any books by her will open your mind about, you know, just if you're not a spiritual person, it's still an interesting read.
Is she 7 Spiritual Laws of Success? Is that one of hers?
She gets into a lot of, I don't think anything about success. Yeah, she does actually. There's one book where it basically talks about the process of creating, you know, done by thought, and how it really happens in not only this physical realm, but in the spiritual realm. So definitely check her out. I don't want to give out too much, because it's all her books. She's got like over 14 books, I think, and I'm already read 5.
That's
and
great.
It's just like, I'm all about it, you know? The other one is The 4-Hour Work Week was huge, especially in creating systems.
Sure.
It definitely introduced me to virtual assistants, and, you know, anything by Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I'm reading Rocket Fuel and Traction. That's huge.
Yeah, those are good ones. Great.
Dave got me into Esther Hicks and all her books about Law of Attraction. Mm-hmm. Big believer in that. You know, in this real estate game, there's so many highs and lows. And if your mindset isn't right, you're
so
in trouble.
So true. So true. What's one of your favorite motivational or business quotes?
Well, one recently, when I was working out, I follow The Rock. You follow The Rock?
He's incredibly inspirational.
Oh, man.
Especially on Pinterest. And I mean, he's incredible.
So his quote is...
Or Instagram, too.
Yeah, Instagram. He's all over the place. When you walk up to opportunity's door, don't knock. Kick that bitch in, smile, and introduce yourself.
I love it. I love
his approach. You know, don't wait for opportunities. Create opportunities is what I've, you know, got from that. You know, if you're sitting there waiting around for the phone to ring, no, you got to call people. You got to pick up the phone. You know, if you're out there driving around, looking at houses, call the We Buy Houses guys. Call them up. See what they're up to. See if they have deals. See if they're looking to sell or buy. You need to make yourself known. People need to know what you do. Grant Cardone. I follow him on
Periscope.
And he's like, if somebody doesn't know him, then he takes it as that's his fault. You know, I apologize that you don't know me.
I know. Right. I've heard him say that before. Right.
So it's like, if people don't know me, that's my fault. I got to let everybody know in this business who I am, how I can help them, and just add value to whatever they're doing.
Yeah, the 10X rule by Grant Cardone is a great book as well.
Mm-hmm.
Great, great book.
There's another quote too I wanted to share. You are the average of the 5 people you spend the most time with. And that's Jim Rohn.
Yes. One of my favorites.
Very recently, I think a big part of our success is that Dave and I, when I say we're part of this mastermind group that you're a part of. And it's just, we're so grateful to be a part of that. You know, I can't stress it enough. Every year, every meeting, I come out of it just
Pumped up.
Feeling grateful and blessed and pumped up, you know, all the energy from everybody. You know, it's just, it's like a family. I mean, super grateful to be a part of that.
I agree.
Know, if Jason's getting on your web, on your podcast, you know, I appreciate you, Jason.
Yes, he is. And, be very, very soon. He's going to be, and we're being interviewing old, good old Jay. I know him for a long time. And you're referencing Collective Genius. Many of the guests have been on here, have been, involved in the Collective Genius, and it is incredible. It'll be in the show notes if you're interested in being a part of that mastermind. And he's capped out right now, so he's I think he's starting another section of. There's three of them now, 30 people in each one. So I think the next one's gonna be Collective Genius 4. So interesting, but it's great. Fantastic mastermind. And it, like you said, it's like a family. It's like a business fraternity in a way.
Yeah, it really is.
What's one of your favorite mobile apps that you use in business every day?
Man, Dropbox every day. There's something new in Dropbox. You guys got to get on Dropbox if you haven't.
Dropbox is incredible. Yes.
There's some new social media apps that I'm going to start using. One of them is Periscope. Just so that, you know, I just from what you told me today, you know, you got some buyers from that. It's huge.
Yes.
I'm using some, there's one. I don't have my phone. It's in the next room, but the meditation app. What is that called? Calm.
Calm or Headspace? There's two of them. Calm's good. It has the music in the background. That's good.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So been using that to take breaks.
That's great.
Just kind of clear my, you know, my mind and kind of disconnect for a little bit.
Yes.
I love the one photo of the beach, kind of the waves rolling in, the sun's going down. I mean, I love the beach. So that's a good app. I have a gratitude app.
I love that. I got that same one, the gratitude app.
Pops up, 9 o'clock. What are you grateful for?
First day, yep.
Yep, and then you just list everything you're grateful for.
Yes, three things, yep. Yes.
And then it comes up with a nice quote too. So yes. That's cool. Yeah. And I got, you know, those are just some. I got a lot of apps. You know, I'm on my phone all the time. So, yeah. So anyways.
That's good. No, those are great. What's your morning routine or do you have one?
I do. I get up typically around, I'm averaging like 6:30, get up. I go straight downstairs, let my dogs out. I make, I get some coffee. Put some protein, a scoop of protein in there, and then
in your coffee?
In my coffee. It's pretty good. You should try it. So scoop of protein and then like a tablespoon of coconut oil. And I'm sipping on my my coffee, and then I'm usually reading something, and I'm reading any book that I was reading the night before. So I'll read a little bit, take the dogs out. Go outside, and it's kind of right now when I go outside, it's still kind of dark. So I'm just taking a kind of like a moment to myself to just kind of sink in, you know, get into my gratitude app and list things that I'm grateful for. Try not to go right into, emails right away. Mm-hmm. So I'm usually doing that in the morning before I go to the gym. One of the things that I do in the morning is definitely go to the gym. So all that, I get up, make my coffee, take the dogs out. You know, my girlfriend's been out of town, but if she's in town, I'll say goodbye to her, and have her go about her day. Then I go straight to the gym. I'm doing, a lot of high intensity stuff. And then in the gym, get dressed and, you know, go to work, go to my office. If not, go to an appointment.
Gotcha. Yeah.
That's it. So it's getting some reading done. You know, I typically don't eat anything in the morning. I like to kind of work out an empty stomach. And usually there's that protein and the coconut oil gets you going.
Right, yeah.
And you're burning that and, you know, you're not passing out when you're working out or anything.
Right. Well, that works for you pretty well then.
Yeah, I like it. I feel good in the morning. I feel like if I don't work out in the morning, I feel lost.
Just, yeah, I hear you. Yeah.
You know, it's like... It's kind of like forgetting something at home or something like that. You just kind of like, oh man, I gotta go get that, or I gotta do that. You know, you're just out of whack for me.
Same thing. It's the same thing. You have to have to take care of your body. Your body's meant to move, not meant to stay in one place for too long. And you got to get your blood flowing, man. Everything is cranking from that point on.
Yeah, I see you at the gym too in those collective genius meetings. Yeah. So there's usually an early morning gym crowd.
A little early morning gym crowd. You got it. What's one of the greatest lessons that you've learned that's helped you get to where you are today, RJ?
Okay, that's a good question. I would say, definitely in this business, get out of your comfort zone. And it's cliche-ish when I say that, or in other words, you know, if you feel like something is holding you back, you know, there's like something that's holding you back, definitely go and do it. For a while, I was very shy. You know, if you would have met me in 2007, maybe 2008, I probably would have never come up and introduce myself and say, hey, you know, my name is this, and you know, I'm a real estate investor. So I do. What do you do? I was too shy. I actually had to work on myself. I got a life coach, and I worked on that. Wow. Coming out of my shell, being comfortable in my own skin. You know, I mean, it was super uncomfortable. But if in this business, if you're not going to get yourself uncomfortable, if you're not going to, you know, go and network with new people, meet new people, talk to strangers, whatever, you're not going to really go far. You know, it's really, this business is based around your network and getting out there and meeting people. And that was the biggest thing. And this life coach, I'm very grateful to have done that exercise with him and did that coaching with him. It really got me to kind of just be comfortable being uncomfortable.
Let's talk about that a little bit. At what point would you recommend hiring a coach or a mentor? And do elaborate a little bit more how important that's been to your success today.
Oh, man. I would say if you're wanting to go somewhere or get somewhere, so we'll just use real estate as an example, since that's what we're talking about. If you going back to when I hired somebody locally, so I wanted to do deals in my market. And, you know, for me and how I've succeeded in life is I've always looked at or followed successful people. Always kind of saw what they did, and they kind of leave clues, you know, of success, right, how they do it. So always follow those clues. And
someone said that success leaves clues.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. So, you know, I saw an opportunity to get mentoring right when I was so close to doing these deals, Corey. I had like two properties in contract. Well, it turned out that these deals weren't deals. I was into them for, you know, $10,000-$15,000 of what actual true buyers were paying for.
And you were excited just because you were in the thick of it, right? Like, I'm in the thick of it, but it wasn't a deal.
Wasn't a deal. And I'm, right, you know, I had it out there and no phone calls from buyers, nothing, you know? Right. And he told me, it's like, hey, this part of town, you want to be at this number.
Right. A coach told you that.
Coach told me that. Yeah.
Gotcha.
And so he, you know, and one big thing too was, I was looking, I didn't have the MLS back then, and I was looking at older comps, and it was right when the market was just, it kind of took a turn here in Columbus. And so I had to kind of, he gave me a tip of how to, you know, how to get those MLS comps from realtors in town. So, you know, I got a quick lesson and, you know, hiring a mentor definitely sped up or kind of shortened that learning curve. So I would recommend getting one very early in your career, you know, as a real estate investor. And it really just comes down to, you know, how fast do you want to see success in what you're doing?
Right.
You know, that's what mentors are for. They cut the learning curve. I'm very grateful for every single mentor that I've, you know, got mentorship from, and I'm open. I'm always open to learning something new every day. There's something new.
I can see that between you, you know? And Dave. I mean, both of you guys have this learning spirit. It's really incredible. Yeah. It's inspiring. It's a beautiful thing. What are you most grateful for today?
In this moment right now, I'm grateful for grateful for my business partner. I'm grateful for you inviting me here. You know, I'm grateful for the capital partners that we do a lot of business with, our small staff, you know, and their patience with me and dealing with me. I'm grateful for the opportunities every day. Kind of, there's always something new. Like today, I was texting with a new buyer, you know, get to know him a little bit. We're doing a meetup. I don't know if Dave told you this, but we're doing a meetup where we want to really build more solid relationships with our buyers.
Right. Face to face at a meeting. Right.
Right. Because everything is just kind of all through email. You don't see the face to the name. You may see the videos, but you never see us in person, you know?
Lose that. Right.
So, I mean, that's what I'm grateful for. I'm grateful for in my app today, I'm grateful for, you know, the love for my girlfriend, the companionship for my dogs, you know, waking up, you know, little things like that. And as you can tell, I'm grateful for a lot of stuff.
I can. It's great though. If you had to summarize it, RJ, why do you do what you do? Why?
I want to definitely create generational wealth. You know, my biggest thing is I don't have a family. I will have a family, and I want to make sure that when I start that family, my kids are going to be okay and their kids are going to be okay.
Sure.
Growing up, we didn't have everything that we wanted. And what I'm finding out is you can have whatever you want in this life. It's all a mindset thing. That's what I want to do. I want to make sure that I leave some sort of impact here, with my family, friends, and come out of this and leave this place better than I found it. You know what I mean?
All right.
So that's what I'm doing.
I love it. I already asked Dave this before, so I know you work as partners, but if there's a way someone can get in touch with you, or what's the best way that our audience can serve you, RJ? What are you looking for now? How's the best way to contact you?
Yeah. Go to our website. www.columbusturnkeyhouses.com.
We'll put that in the notes for sure.
Yeah, I pop up on the left-hand corner. You can schedule a strategy call with me. Let's talk about how we can help you with your real estate goals, whether it's rental properties, whether it's fixer-upper properties. And you can just call us. And our office phone goes straight to us. It gets directed to our cell phone. So right now, we're very easy to get a hold of. You know, I'm on Facebook. You can connect with me there. I'm on LinkedIn, and recently just joined Periscope. So you'll see me there shortly. Don't do that much on Twitter, but you know, if you Google my name, RJ Pepino, I pop up. So I'm very easy to get a hold of.
I'll have your spelling of your name in the notes too. So make sure they get it.
Awesome.
I thank you so much for being on here. I appreciate you taking the time. It's really obvious how you and Dave are just crushing it. And a lot of it's because of the camaraderie and the way that you understand each other whenever you're working together. And also, it sounds like you have very aligned, similar goals on where you want to go and benchmarks on how to get there. And just the ideal and the mindset that you have is so crucial, because pressure, I talked about this day in a Periscope, pressure will crush you if you fold, but you have two choices under pressure. You can either flex or fold. And I really love the idea of flexing under pressure and letting it expand you and make you stronger and better and stretching you so you can be all that you want to be for your future family, for your generational wealth, big audacious goal that you have for your future family, for your girlfriend, for your relationship that you have now in your business. Just being able to look at that every day and having that choice of whether, you know, I'm going to flex or fold is really cool. And it's awesome that you're choosing to flex, and it's obvious why you're so successful because of that. And you're just embracing that pressure in a way that it's positive and not negative. So hats off to you, RJ, for that.
Thank you, Corey. I appreciate that, man. It means a lot.
Yeah. I appreciate you being on here. Thank you again for taking the time to listen to our Nether Profit Masters podcast. I really appreciate your time greatly. You know, we've had some amazing guests on here. RJ is another one, and make sure you do not miss the next one. Make sure you subscribe over at Real Estate Profit Master. If you haven't already subscribed over there, you can do that. realestateprofitmasters.com. If you happen to just pop over on the website, it's realestateinvestingprofits.com. Make sure you download your investing guide and do not miss our next interview. It will be incredible, and we'll continue to bring the very best of the best and those investors that are willing to share what's working and so they can help you out. So thank you again, RJ. Remember, be a servant, and we'll talk to you later. Bye now.
All right. Take it easy, Corey. See ya.
Bye.
You've been listening to another Real Estate Investing Profits Master Podcast Series. To receive your free real estate book, Down and Dirty, Ultimate Real Estate Investing Quick Start Guide, how to quit your job to start flipping houses in 90 days or less, head online and go to realestateinvestingprofits.com. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/realestateinvestingprofits. Thanks again for listening, and stay tuned for our next episode.